Hi everyone, welcome to this week's episode of Tuesday Tips with Tabitha. Today what we want to talk about is utilizing conditional content in your email campaigns. Conditional content is a feature that allows you to really choose the content that you're putting in front of your contacts. It's a plus plan and above feature, so you can utilize it in any way that you'd like to make the most sense for your campaigns. You can see here that Boone's Bandanas is getting ready to send out their fall newsletter. So we want to use conditional content to talk to our different kind of customers, but have it all come from the same campaign. So what we're going to do, you'll see here as we continue to scroll down, we have a section that is specific to our customers. These are the people that are buying our products, our bandanas, our harnesses, our leashes, whatever it might be, and we want to speak specifically to them here. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to click on this text box, click on our little gear, and we're going to make it conditional. So this is going to allow us to only show this block to somebody who meets these conditions. Our conditions are going to be tag exists, contact type, and you'll see here we have different ones: animal shelter, pet owner, general interest. So if you have the general interest tag, we want you to see this section. So you'll see now that we've applied this condition, it will only show this section to people with the tag general interest. This is a really good way to get your content in front of people in the same campaign, but really segment it in a way that makes sense for the individual. We always talk a lot about right message, right person, right time, right medium. This is an excellent way to do that. As we continue to scroll down, we can make our call to actions conditional as well. It would make sense to do that for this exact button because this button is directly related to this text block. However, you can see here that if you're an animal shelter, which is Boone's Bandana's other type of customer or contact, we want to make sure that you see this content block. So what we're going to do is we're going to make this conditional as well. We're going to do the same exact thing, tag exists, and we'll type in contact type. And since our tag is already created, we can just select animal shelter. Now you'll see here, people will only see this block again if they have the animal shelter tag. And the reason for this is we're really communicating in two different ways with these two different types of contacts. It's not super necessary for animal shelter contacts to see the things of the people that are actually purchasing our products. Now, maybe we want to put a general text block or introduction paragraph above this that everybody's going to see. A really good best practice would to include an intro paragraph and then get specific in the things that you want to send to your different groups of contacts. There's a lot of different ways that you can use conditional content within your campaigns to get really specific on the people that you're reaching within one campaign. If you're using conditional content or you have a creative use behind it, please let us know in the comments. We are always super excited to hear from you guys. Otherwise, we'll chat with you next Tuesday.